welcome back to our new series on the armor of God. In this series, we're going to learn about what the armor of God is and why it's so important. But you might be thinking, Miss Hannah, why does God want me to wear armor? I mean, that would be so hot and heavy, and I'm not even fighting in a war. But remember that the Bible says that we are. But it's not a physical battle, it's a spiritual battle against God's enemy, Satan. And so our armor that God gives us is a spiritual armor to fight this spiritual battle, right? It's not physical armor, so it's not going to be too hot or too heavy. But this spiritual armor, they're going to be tools to protect us against the enemy and his lies. So, I am super excited to learn about the belt of truth with you guys today. But first, let's sing our new verse song that we learned last week. So let's stand up together and sing it loud. Here we go. Awesome job with our new song, you guys. Memorizing God's word is so important in our fight against the enemy. All right, today we're going to be talking about the belt of truth, which is the first piece of armor that Paul mentions in Ephesians 6. So we mentioned last week that when Paul was writing this letter, he was most likely imagining the Roman soldier when he was talking about these different pieces of armor, and that's who the people would have pictured when they read this letter from Paul. So kind of with that image in mind of the Roman soldier, and I think Pastor Steve is going to show you a picture again of a Roman soldier, so you'll see it again later. So with that image in mind, we're going to talk for a second about what the belt did for a Roman soldier, okay? So it carried the sheath, which is kind of like the covering that the sword goes into. It held that on his waist so that when he wasn't using his sword, he could put it right there into his belt in the sheath. It also had some pieces of really strong metal that hung down from the belt that protected his lower body. And then on top of these two things, it really kind of held the whole piece of armor that he was wearing, a Roman soldier, kind of held it all together. And the breastplate, it was secured down by the belt. And so when someone's running into battle, that all of his armor was not flapping all over the place, the belt of truth kind of held everything together. So it's really cool that Paul uses the belt as the thing that represents truth, kind of as holding everything together. So let's talk about truth for a minute. So what is truth? Well, we would say that God's words are truth. And where do we find God's words? The Bible, yes. We find God's words in the Bible, and so we hold this as truth. And it's so important that we know what the Bible says. What is the truth that's in here, right? It's important that we know it. The truth about who God is, the truth about who we are in Him, the truth about who the enemy is, right? The Bible says that Satan is the father of lies. He loves to take truth and change it a little bit and then see if we'll fall for a half-truth or a lie, right? He wants to deceive us into sin or into being discouraged or into being fearful, right? Or into hating somebody. So, for example, you might think one day, I'm not loved. Nobody loves me, right? You might have that thought in your mind. But if you know God's word and the truth that is in here, you can say, no, I actually know that God loves me. And it says that nothing in all of creation can separate me from His love. And so that's a lie, Satan, and I'm not going to believe you, right? And so truth is what holds everything else together in our life. Just like how the belt on a Roman soldier kind of holds all the armor in place. So we're going to talk more about the belt of truth with Pastor Steve and have some fun, of course. So here we go. Let's go see what they're doing over there. Next level.
Hi guys, welcome to my new show called Next Level Sports Edition. Woo! Where we help you take your sports skills, are you ready, to the next level. Woo! Hey, there's nothing more beautiful, more unbelievably fun to watch than two teams coming together in the heat of battle and competing against one another. It's like this. You've got two teams. They come there and they meet each other. You got this team over here, you got this team over here. And this team wants to go this way, but you can't do that because this guy, he's waiting for him. He makes the block here. This guy comes around. This guy, you can't do that either. He makes a reverse, and next thing he's in for the touchdown. Yeah! Look at that. That's what it's all about. And today, I want to show you how I help some kids take their sports skills to the next level. I found two kids. They were just ordinary kids, and you know, they had some skills, but they weren't next level skills. I helped turn them into next level ninjas. Take a look at this, and we'll watch these guys take their sports skills to the next level. Next level. What's up, guys? Welcome back to my new show called Next Level Sports. It's where I take your everyday, average, boring sports and we take them to the next level! Next level! Today we're gonna hear from my good friends Kayla and Kylie as they struggle to take karate to the next level. Let's see what they said. I definitely see the problem here and I know how to fix this. The three fundamentals to karate are power, control, and trust in your sensei. So I'm gonna help Kayla and Kylie take their karate to the next level!
Next level!
Let's do this! Oh, but first, check out this next level coaching tip.
Next level!
Welcome back to Next Level Coaching Tips. In this episode, we're gonna teach you how to cheer like a sports fanatic. Step one, we're gonna learn the touchdown. We're gonna go elbows, 90 degree angle, arms above the head, and you're gonna pump it. You're gonna pump it. Pump it like this, pump it like that. Touchdown, you can spin, touchdown. You can spin, touchdown, like that. Grab an air horn, touchdown. The second cheer is called the slow clap. This doesn't seem like much, but trust me, if you get this going in a nice big group of people, you could get the stadium roaring. Here we go, we start like this, just a low, slow clap, right? But then you build, you make some eye contact, and before you know it, you're an air horn will spice any cheer up, trust me, okay. Number three, this one's called the Rocky. Guys, thanks for being here. Thanks for tuning in to Next Level Coaching Tips. We'll see you next time.
Next level.
Kylie, Kayla, what are you guys doing?
We just watched a karate kid, and we're trying to do some sweet karate moves.
Yeah, Next Level Sensei Coach Steve, we're trying to earn our black belts.
Oh, okay. I see what's going on here, and I think I know how to help you guys take your karate to the next level.
Next level.
You guys have to understand that karate's all about truth, and you can't get your black belt yet until you've put in the work to earn it. So, to help you take your karate to the next level, I'll be right back.
Next level.
Kayla, Kylie, to help you take your karate skills to the next level, I got you each your very own ninja in training t-shirt and your white belt. This will help you take your karate to the next level.
Next level.
Thanks, but we want a black belt instead.
Yeah, I think you got us the wrong color.
That's a very good point. But in order to get your black belt, you have to earn it. So you start as a white belt. But how do you get your black belt? I'm glad you asked. Introducing Sensei Chu.
Wah!
Sensei Chu, thank you for being here, sir. Sensei Chu is gonna teach you guys the art of karate and take your karate to the next level.
Next level.
Are you ready?
Yeah!
Let's take it to the next level.
Next level.
Go start your karate training. This does make me wonder though. Have we even scratched the surface of next level? Is this next level enough? Is there a nexter level? We've gotta think bigger.
Pause! All right, that was cool. Now, our two karate students and Sensei Chu, they were awesome. But I'll tell you the truth, they weren't next level awesome. And I started thinking about their equipment, especially their belt. I needed to create a next level belt so they could have next level karate skill. You know the belt's important because for someone who's participating in karate, the belt, it holds their coat in place, but it also gives a truthful representation of their karate skills. But you remember we're talking about putting on the armor of God and how each piece of the armor of God or the equipment that God gives us to fight our enemy. Although it's invisible, it's very, very real. And we've been looking at the Roman soldier because that's what the Apostle Paul, when he wrote those words in Ephesians and he told us about God's armor, he was relating it to a Roman soldier. The Roman soldier has this belt that goes around his waist. And in Ephesians, it says that we're to put on the belt of truth. Now, for a Roman soldier, that was very important because the belt actually held all of his equipment in place. If his belt came off, his sword would fall off, and his armor would be loose. The belt held everything in place. And that's what the belt of truth does for us. And the belt of truth is us knowing and living out God's word. Because we're in a battle, remember? We have good, that's God, against evil, that's Satan. And they're warring against each other. And it is really happening. And what Satan tries to do is he tries to put just a little bit of a lie in some truth. So we get confused. He tries to mix them all together. But if we know God's word, if we read God's word, if we memorize it, then we will know the truth and it will be here and it will be here as well. And then when the enemy tries to deceive us, he tries to trick us, we'll know what he's up to and then we can defeat the enemy. Because the belt of truth for us as Christ followers, it holds everything in place, just like the belt for the Roman soldier held everything in place. And for our karate students, the belt holds everything in place. So just as it tells us in Ephesians chapter 6, to put on the belt of truth. Let's know God's word, learn God's word, memorize it, and then live it out every day. By doing so, you're putting on the belt of truth and you're strong and you're ready for anything that the enemy might throw against you. All right, guys, now we're gonna go back to the video and we're gonna see how I take these guys to the next level!
Next level.
Kylie, Kayla, come here. I know how to take your karate training to the next level. Not only am I gonna give you white belts and training from Sensei Chu, but we're gonna upgrade those belts to actual ninja utility belts. Check this out.
Wow.
Not only are these real authentic ninja utility belts, but they're also equipped with throwing stars, mini explosives, and even smoke grenades. Now your karate has truly been taken to the next level.
Next level!
Next level.
Oh man, I hope you guys had a lot of fun today with Pastor Steve and his younger self. All right, I just want to close out our time together today briefly by talking about how exactly we wear the belt of truth. So if truth is something that's going to be so helpful to us against the enemy, where is truth? The Bible, yes. And how do we know what truth is? How do we know what's in between these pages? Yeah, you have to read it, right? We have to open it and read it. And if you can't read yet, then I sure hope that your parents are reading it to you, or your big brothers or sisters, right? Or maybe you're hearing about it at Sunday school, or maybe through TV shows or other books, right? So it's so important that we know what is in this book. We know truth, right? And it's especially helpful if we memorize it, like we talked about earlier today. When we have God's words, when we have verses memorized in our mind, when we're in a tough situation or something discouraging or scary comes at us and we have God's words memorized, we can come back so quickly with the truth of God's word, right? So it's so important that we know it and that we're in it regularly so that we just constantly have truth going through our minds. So guys, so important that we're in God's word, that we're talking about it with our parents, with our brothers and sisters, with our friends, right? That we are standing firm on God's truth. And that way, we're not gonna fall for the lies of the enemy. So I have one last special treat for you guys today. We're gonna learn a little quick song that is the list of the armor of God. Maybe not in order, but it's the list nonetheless to help us memorize what each of the pieces are. So if you wanna sing this with us today, I think we're gonna play it every week going forward. Just a fun little end to our time together, all right? So here's the armor of God. I'll see you guys next week as we talk about the breastplate of righteousness. Have a great week, you guys. Bye-bye. Ready, march.
Put on the armor, the armor, the armor of God. Put on the armor, the armor, the armor of God. Belt of truth, gospel boots, breastplate of righteousness. Shield of faith, sword of spirit, helmet of salvation. Belt of truth, gospel boots, breastplate of righteousness. Shield of faith.